listen, cause everybody knows. Yeah, everybody knows. And I can feel your body shaking every single touch. That's just how it goes. That's just how it goes. Oh, I find it so hard being addicted to your love. I find it so hard being addicted to your touch. I find it so hard knowing that you are just my drug. I find it so hard knowing you treated me like a mark. We ain't gotta talk about it right now, cause every time we talk about it, you stare at the floor. Give me the stars like I thought.
Okay, you guys, here are some of our ingredients that we're going to need. I try to keep them as simple as possible because it's really not a hard recipe at all, and you really don't need much. We have some flour, and you probably need like a cup of flour, probably not even that. I kind of cut the recipe in half. Need some onion and bell pepper, some parsley, some green onion. Some corn, make sure your corn is drained. You don't want to put half the water in the corn from the can and everything like that. Or if you want to use the frozen one, that's fine too. So we have some bacon that's going to go on top as the garnishment for our bisque. Here we have some heavy whipping cream. You can either use heavy whipping cream or half and half. Either one works. Or you can do both. It depends how much you're making. If you're making probably a lot, like a big old pot, I would use approximately about 2 quarts. Okay, here we have some crawfish tails, butter, what we're going to need for our roux, tawny sachet, garlic powder, onion powder, parsley, cayenne pepper. You know down here we have to have our cayenne pepper. I don't know about y'all, but I like my food well seasoned. But these are just some of the ingredients that you've seen in the beginning. So, you guys, you're going to saute the onion and the bell peppers until they're transparent, which is see-through salt. While your onion and bell pepper are simmering and cooking down, you might want to put your roux on. Let your butter get hot, and then you add your flour. You're going to add you about 2 sticks of butter for 1 cup of flour. And right now, we see it's getting kind of hot. And we want this to go to like a peanut butter color. Once it gets to that, then we're ready to go. But right now, we're still waiting for our butter to melt. And then we're going to add our flour. Okay, now you guys, as you can see, my roux is almost ready. So I put it on low until my other pot comes to a boil. And then I'll add the roux. But I put it on low until this comes to a boil. Now, I added the green onion, the parsley, the corn, the crawfish, and the half and half. Don't worry if it's a little watery right now because the roux will thicken it up. And it is heavy whipping cream. So, don't worry. You have time. You can always save it. Don't rush it. Next, what I'm going to do is season it with the Tony, the garlic powder, and the onion powder. Now, you can season it to your liking. It's up to you. Okay, y'all. I am finally coming to the bowl, and that's the moment we've been waiting for. Now, we're about to add our roux. Okay, so we added the roux, and as you can see, it has thickened almost instantly, well, instantly. And now, we're going to let it simmer about 25 to 30 minutes, just so it could thicken some more, I mean. But it's all about the consistency that you want. While I'm waiting for the base to thicken, I kind of got like some little croissants to go on the side. You can serve it with whatever you want, but most likely it's croissants, bread, or anything like that, what people serve it with. So I'm going to make a little butter spread, quickly, easy. Put it on there and then put it in the oven and let the butter melt or whatever. Here are the butter spreads after I've put the butter on there, the croissants, excuse me. After I put the butter on there, and I was just going to put them in the oven for probably like a minute or two. You know, you don't want them to get too hard. We're only trying to melt the butter. Told y'all. A minute. See how beautiful that looks? Just a little garnish. Parsley ain't nothing but garnish. It don't have no taste. But I don't know about you. I like for my food to look good and taste good. See how much of a difference that make? Almost done, you guys. And when it's almost done, I kind of like to get an early start on my plating. I'm real big on presentation. What I've learned is using white plates and white things to plate your food and display your food, it really brings the colors out. So always try to use, you know, you're trying to grab people's attention with your food, use white plates, white bowls, whatever, white saucers, whatever you have and things like that. So I have the croissants that I use and I have the bacon. Remember I had the bacon earlier and I told y'all we were going to be using it to put on top of the bisque and some green onions, you know, just for garnishment. Y'all, and for dessert, I did a brookie. I did out the box, y'all. I ain't do from scratch. But if you can't even bake from out the box and you want me to do a tutorial on how to do it, let me know. Hey, y'all. She ready. Here it is. And this is before the garnish. I just want you to see how thick it became. Okay, you guys, that is it for the crawfish and corn bisque. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. Tell someone to tell someone about my channel. I have a lot more mukbangs coming up. I have some people coming on the show. Hope to see you next time. Y'all, shout out to Jasmine Alexander. We played a game early on Facebook and she guessed right that I was cooking crawfish and corn bisque.